Hi, this is Masia, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to give your first apps with Scriptcase. Scriptcase is an efficient web development low-code platform that helps you to create web systems, business applications, and reports fast and easy. This is the login screen where you can choose the language to use Scriptcase. Let's log as admin and choose English. Once you're in for the first time, you will see this pop-up informing you that you can interact with our technical support anytime. Using this chat to get any help you might need during the evaluation process. This is the main menu where you can set, for example, new users to share a Scriptcase environment with you, but you will see that most of the options will be not active. It will be available just after you create your new project. Here you can create your project. A project can be a system with one or more related applications and common settings. During the project creation, the Scriptcase will guide you to set the extension for the project. Let's create our first project. First, you have to decide whether to create a project from scratch using the blank application or using a template. The templates are applications created by our development team to help you with examples. Let's choose blank project and name the application. Okay, next. Here, you will set the language for the project. Scriptcase will help you with general translations and regional settings. There's also a data dictionary to help you to model the labels and field types. Let's choose English as main language and Spanish as a second language. Now, in the third step, you are going to select the layout for the applications, CSS and HTML. Scriptcase provides you some templates from which you can customize or create your own. Let's choose SC-Hino and go next. Database connections. Scriptcase connects with the most popular relational database, and it also has a generic layer, ODBC. For this example, I will choose MySQL, and I will connect to a database project that I've previously created for this video, with some basic tables and dummy records. Let's type the username, password, list database, samples en, create. Okay, we are finished with the basic settings, and now you can start creating the applications. Here you can also see some useful links such as samples, videos, forum, support, documentation, and courses. They are all very useful for you to learn about Scriptcase during this evaluation period. Let's check out the applications. Grid application is one of the most important. You can use for many purposes. It is used to display data from one or more table, and using the grid, you can create reports, summaries, charts, and so on. Beside the grid, you can also create graphics using the chart application. It has more options for you to customize. The form application you can use to manage the data, create, read, update, and delete. The control application is similar to a form. However, it does not necessarily connect to a table. You can use for validations as in a login screen, for example. The search application to make data selection and filter. It comes also integrated with the applications of grid, form, and chart, for example. Then you have the menus. It can be vertical, horizontal, or three menu, and helps you to organize the applications hierarchically. Here you have the tabs that are useful when you need to create tabs with applications inside. The menu application has also tabs automatically integrated. The PDF report is useful to create PDF templates, as an invoice, for example. Dashboards to provide you at a glance views of KPIs of your system. The blank helps you to develop advanced validations, business rules, or even complete apps. It works as an IDE integrated to Scriptcase with macros, libraries, methods, and functions. Finally, we have the calendar application for you to create calendars with native components or integrated with Google Calendar. Okay, now that you learned a bit about each application, I will show you a quick example of what can be done. let's start creating a form application. I'm going to use here the table of sales and create. Once you are inside the form application, you will see here that Scriptcase will organize all the options inside this menu. And then you can use the options to customize. Without doing any change, I will run the application to present you the basic form. Here we have a basic form. You will note that Scriptcase is recognizing all the data types because Scriptcase is reading the tables and it brings to the application all the fields just in the way it is set inside the database. You have here the pagination to go through the form pages. You have here the record count, and you have the buttons to include, save, and delete. And you have also this quick search where you can search for a record inside the form options. If you try to include, we are going to have a blank form for us to include a new record to the database. As I told you before, this database has already some dummy records for us to show the examples. Back to Scriptcase environment, I'm going to close the form application and create a new application of grid. Let's choose grid application, and here I'm going to choose the same table of sales so we can do a small report to show you the options that we have inside the grid application. So let's create. Same way we have inside the form applications, here we have the grid options for you to customize. Before we do any change, let's run the application so I can present you the basic grid. And here you can see that we have a view of this data we have inside the table of sales. We have some buttons, for example, to organize the columns of the school hand grid. I can also sort the data according to a certain field. I can do a quick search to search for a specific product, for example. I can also use that advanced search and add more fields here. And I can navigate through the pages. Here we can export to different formats. Okay, now let's link the grid application to the form application we have already created. I will choose here application links, and we are going to create a new link. The option I'm going to choose is edit link because I want to edit my grid application using a form. So we are going to choose the form sales we've just created. Here I'm going to link with the field ID. And finally, I can set here some options for the link. Like for example, display a new button inside the grid in order for me to create a new record directly. So let's set here yes, save, and run to see the change. Okay, now we have the include button here for me to include a new record inside the grid. Or I can edit the record directly from the grid application. Save and go back. Now I'm going to show you how to group this grid according to a product category, for example. Let's go back to the grid application. I will choose here group by option, static group by, and new group by. So let's group by category and date by month. We have here the options. Let's choose month, x-axis, and I wanna have the quantity sold to analyze. Run. And now we have the grid grouped by product category and month. And we can see here the summary to review the information or to check out a graphic with the same information. We can also go back here and export to a PDF and choose here the columns that I want to export, add a password or other options available here. Once the generation is finished, we can view the PDF. Okay, we have here the PDF And the layout can be customized inside Scriptcase. We have also here the bookmarks where we can see by product category, or we can access the charts as well, or the summary, everything inside this PDF. And back here to the grid application, you will have many, many options to play with. Let's continue our example by creating a chart application and accessing the same table of sales. So I just want to show how to create the same graphic using the chart application. Let's use product category, date, per month, and the metric will be quantity sold. Okay, so we can run the application and we have now a chart with the same information. The difference here is that we have many options to play with. We can change the layout, or we can add customized fields here to play inside the chart. Okay, so now we can finish our example by creating a menu application, so we can put all applications together. Let's create the menu. I will import here the applications we've created so far. The grid is the report. And the form to add new records. Let's choose here another theme. And inside menu settings, we are going to add a default application for the background of my system. So we can use the chart application as background. It can be also a dashboard. And we are going to show the icons to have our final menu. So we have the reports, we have the form, and the chart in the background. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show you as a first step, reminding that you can visit our website scriptcase.net and check out more examples inside here, our learning e-learning area. Here you have complete demonstrations, webinars, courses, tutorials, documentation, and etc. You have also the support team here that can assist you. You have the chat options here as well, and you can talk to us to get some help during your evaluation period. I hope this video was useful, and I see you next video. Bye bye.